the links between your continent and Ypres, and I've seen in the book, are numerous and warm, cordial and faithful. Even after nearly 100 years, we are grateful towards the young military man who came from another part of the world, your side, to fight here in the mud of Flanders, for our integrity and for the values which it is, freedom, democracy and peace. It is a good and appropriate that we still commemorate the soldiers of your county who fought and died here so far from their home. Years have gone by since the end of the First World War, but the memory and the gratitude towards your country remains. Day after day, under the Menin Gate, the buglers sound the last post, and the words of the exhortation, at the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them, remind us of the offer of soldiers of all over the world. This is for the people of Ypres the best evidence that we will never forget the offer of the soldiers amongst the, also the Fiji victims. We have the duty to remember and to remind year after year that the offer of the man and woman was not at all in vain, that this was the price that had to be paid for us to live in democracy and freedom. Mr. President, let us work together over the borders of the continents for a better and a safer world where our children and grandchildren can be happy and can dream of a nice future. Thank you for your visit.
I would just like to say how honored I am. And my delegation are also honored to be here on this occasion. We are here on an educational visit. The history of Fiji and the history of the Fiji military forces is reflected in the fields of Flanders. And the beginning of the forces saw baptism by fire in Flanders. At the outbreak of the First World War, Fiji did not send a contingent at the beginning of the war. So Fiji citizens left Fiji, went across to Australia and joined the Australian forces, went to New Zealand, did the same thing, went to Canada, did the same thing, went to the United States, did the same thing, went to South Africa, did the same thing, because they wanted to serve the king and bring freedom. When later on during the war years was agreed to send a contingent, the first contingent arrived after 2015. And altogether the volunteers numbered 1,200. 357 Fijians served here. And also later on the native Fijian was not allowed to serve in the forces. We had had earlier on in our history a bad case of measles and the flu, and it reduced the population in Fiji by a third. Mm-hmm. The flu and the measles are very simple disease, but it was a new thing. And so when the war happened and the contingents were allowed to come, the government made the ruling that no Fijians would come. But on the insistence of the Fijians, the native Fijians, to serve, they agreed that they would come and serve in the labor battalion. So 100 Fijians came and served in the labor battalion. Mm-hmm. But they didn't want them to go to the front. So they served in France, in the ports of Calais, mm-hmm. and also in Italy, in Taranto. And those members of the Fiji contingent and the labor force, those who died here are buried here. And in Memnon Gate, there are 14 of the first contingent and second contingent were here. And there are others. And I intend in my time to visit all those graves. They're here, they're in Gallipoli, they're in Turkey, they're in Gaza, and elsewhere. And I intend towards that, visit all those areas. So that the future generation of Fijians will learn to appreciate what had taken place by their forefathers, and that they should learn to appreciate that. So that is the reason why I'm here, Lord Mayor, and I'm very honored to be here, but at the same time I feel very sentimental. This is a part of our history that we have recognized but have not fully appreciated. And we want to do that. We owe it to the people who served here in great numbers for a small country.
Yes.
And served willingly. And their descendants are in Fiji. Today.
Okay.
So I will, when I return to Fiji, I will get a copy of the book that I showed you earlier and send it so that you can put it in your
very nice. Thank you.
Library here.
Okay.
Edition of the contribution by Fiji. And I hope that one day you probably might be able to come to Fiji and to see the 300 islands.
My woman is interested.
But every day, every year, on the 11th of November, we have the memorial service at 11 o'clock. And we remember those who participated in the Great War and the Second World War and all the other engagements that the Fiji troops had participated in at the time. So for me, sir, it's a great honor to be here again, and I look forward to coming back sometimes in the future to spend a little more time here and in the other areas.
Okay.
Thank you.
So about yourself and a bit of this town, please.
Yeah, we are very proud. Your Excellency, the President of the Fiji, was here to remember, to commemorate the victims and the soldiers. So from the Fiji, we are very proud and a great thank you. to the people of the Fiji.
This is the first time somebody from Fiji come to visit?
Which is the first time the president of the Fiji is here. The governor general of Australia comes this evening also.
I believe this also strengthens the relationship between Fiji and this country, this town especially?
Yes, we will say thank you for the soldiers to for the freedom, the democracy here in this country, and she the 350 victims we commemorate very graceful.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Nice.